Hola, hello everybody, 我是早安英文的 Jack.
Hola, hello everybody, 我是早安英文的 Alan.
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
So, Alan, 你喜欢 flowers 吗？
Yes, of course. Is there anybody who doesn't love them?
Well, I guess so. I guess that's true. I mean, I don't know. I think they're okay.
But I only love real flowers, not those fake flowers.
Yeah, I'll agree with you. I really don't like the fake fruit as well. That really annoys me. I want to eat it.
Yeah, so in today's podcast, I think we're going to talk about some expressions about flowers, right?
I think that sounds good.
Okay, so now let's get started.那么我们要讲的第一种花就是玫瑰花 Rose、其实我们都知道玫瑰花它是美丽和浪漫的代名词，这个单词也可以用来形容女孩子，形容一个人她是由内而外的美丽， A remarkably beautiful individual inside and out. 比如说、那个女孩真是太好了，她一定是 a rose.
Yeah,
that girl is so nice. She must be a rose.
Exactly.
Sunny must be a rose.
I knew you were going to say that. So, yeah, if a girl is beautiful and just almost perfect in every way, you can call her a rose. So, an example sentence would be, Man, I gotta get me a rose, meaning I really wish that I had a girl like that.
Mm-hmm. So, did you get a rose?
I did get a rose, yeah.
Wow. Yeah.
Did you get a rose, Sunny?
Maybe. 好，那么第二种表达就是 a bed of roses.一床的玫瑰花，这是什么意思呢？其实这个表达的意思，它是说、an easy life， 形容你的生活非常的舒适。比如说，我们可以就是讲这样一个反问句，就是 Who said life would be a bed of roses？
Yes，
谁说生活就是 super easy 的呢？其实并不是这样。
Yeah， so is your life as a teacher a bed of roses, Sunny？
Apparently, it's not.
Yeah, so if you say it's a bed of roses, it means it's a very easy life. Mm-hmm. But you can also say it's no bed of roses, meaning
no bed of roses.
Yeah,
没有一床的玫瑰
definitely not easy.
就是 definitely not easy. 就是很不舒适的那样一种生活，不好的生活。比如说，如果我们有时候看到一些不喜欢的人在自己身边，我们就会觉得这样的情况真的是太不好了，我们就可以说 Being around my ex-boyfriend is no bed of roses. 在我前男友身边我真是觉得很不自在，很不爽。
Okay, so the next one is coming up roses or come up roses. So this is when something turns out really, really well, so extremely well. So if you had your doubts about a project, but then it went according to plan, you could say, oh, it's all come up roses.
还有一个表达就是 come or coming up roses， 表示这个情况好转，可能一开始这个情况非常的不好，但是后来随着事情的发展它变得越来越好了。比如说在工作的时候我们可能对一些东西有一些怀疑，但是后来发现还不错，它事情发展的非常的好，我们就可以说 I had my doubts about this project but now it's coming up roses.
OK, 第二个是 Daisy
小雏菊。
Yeah, so there's a couple of this. 小雏菊。对不起，小雏菊。
So what about them?
Well, daisies represent innocence, happiness, purity, that sort of thing, you know.
其实小雏菊它是象征着幸福、天真和纯洁。
纯洁。So the first one, if you're fresh as a daisy, it means you're eager, enthusiastic, and just, you know, really ready for the day. So usually after sleep.
其实第一个表达就是 be as fresh as a daisy， 这个表达的意思是说非常精神饱满。
So an example sentence would be After getting some sleep I was as fresh as a daisy Or now that I've showered I'm fresh as a daisy。
比如说当你睡完一觉之后或者是洗完澡了之后我整个人就是精神饱满的。 Now that I've showered I'm fresh as a daisy。其实关于这个 daisy 它还有另外一个表达，而这个表达是完全相反的意思，这个表达是 be pushing up the daisies， 其实、直接翻译过来它的意思就是疯狂的扯小雏菊。这个词组在英文中，在英文的俚语中，它表示的意思是死了，挂了， to be dead.
Yeah, so it's usually used in the future tense, so dead and buried. So I'll be pushing up the daisies before this problem is solved.
比如说你想要说你遇到一个非常困难的事情、在这个问题解决之前的话，你觉得自己就快不行了，坚持不住了，你就可以说I'll be pushing up daisies before this problem is solved. 再或者还有一种情况，就是说如果有人他一直在惹你，你就可以对他说 If you talk to me like that again, you'll be pushing up the daisies. Did you hear me, 强子？
我听你。
我听见了。Means I heard it.
Oh, right, okay. 谢谢老师。
不客气。
Yeah, so pushing up the daisies just means that you're dead. It's just an expression to say he's dead without actually having to say he's dead.、
Mm-hmm.
So an example sentence would be, you'll be pushing up the daisies when mum finds out that you dented her brand new car. I would be pushing up the daisies, trust me.
Really?
Yeah.
如果强子的妈妈发现她把她的新车给刮了的话，她也会被揍死吧，应该。好了，我们现在再来看最后一种花儿。这种花就是 violet, 紫罗兰。那么紫罗兰呢、紫罗兰通常呢我们可以用它来形容一些比较害羞的人 extremely shy person.、
Yeah, so、a shrinking violet is usually the expression and it's obviously for a very shy person.、
它通常是和这个 shrinking, 缩小或者说是畏缩的这样一个单词搭配在一起使用，表示非常害羞的人。比如说我们就可以讲在她去上大学之前呢，她整个人都非常的胆小。She was a shrinking violet until she went away to college.
Yeah, so she became more confident, whereas before she was very shy, so she was a shrinking violet before.
所以说她以前啊，上大学以前啊，就是一个非常胆小的人，但上了大学之后，可能就变得 confident, 比较自信了。So Jack, am I a shrinking violet?
No, no way, Jose.
So
no
what
way.
Am I?
You're a, rose. Yeah, yeah, we talked about that earlier.
Oh.
Yeah.
Are you trying to butter me up?
maybe.
Fine.
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
好了，以上就是我们今天节目的所有内容。Thank you guys for listening.
Yeah, thanks very much for listening. I've been Jack.
And I've been Sunny.
See you next time, guys.
Adios, amigos.
Adios, bye-bye.